Dubaku Tukwi Gale Turban Head Wrap An Origin of Sub-Saharan Africa. In slavery days, it was imposed as a badge of enslavement, or black people without power. But because of the strength of my people, turned into a uniform of rebellion, signifying absolute resistance.
Before I continue, have you subscribed? I mean, we had this conversation the other day, but I will not continue until you subscribe. Click that button. I mean, you already liked this first head wrap, so you might as well. Click it, and then I'll continue. You did it? Okay, let's go.
As I was saying before I was rudely interrupted, turned into a uniform of rebellion, signifying absolute resistance to loss of self-definition and a helmet of courage. Head wrap is not just a fabric covering the head. It is magic woven with history. It's a protection from the cold, heat, and elements. Back in slavery day, the slave master would have them wear head wraps so they won't have lice in their hair and things like that. Head wraps in some African culture determines respect, age, marital status, and prosperity of a woman. If head wraps leaned left, she was single. If right, she was married. We wear the head wraps as a queen wears her crown. Churana. Worn mostly now as a statement of peace, a statement piece, or an accessory, or in most cases, let's be real, when we're having a bad hair day. We still wear our head wraps with a sense of pride. Head wraps now are in a conversation of cultural appropriation, but that's a different topic. What do you think? Are black people only supposed to wear head wraps because of the history, or should all women be able to wear head wraps as a sign of unity, a sign of respect for one another? Leave comments down in the section box below. I love you guys so much for watching.
Crash course. Let me hide the money in the dashboard. Max mad, could you lost the brick inside the Porsche? Goofy with the curve, then asking me for intercourse.